I'm going to do a deep dive on the eerie similarities between the late Lisa Lefteye Lopez and protege Natina Reed. You ain't never heard the 9 degrees, they my degrees on loving his philosophies. Unity, the cornerstone that forms the one, two ways to trust. Lefteye was one of the people who discovered Natina, and they later formed the girl group Black.
Three beautiful young ladies,
which was referred to as the kid-friendly TLC. Natina's sort of favorite Lefteye, and they had similar eerie life and death experiences. Here are some things to note. Days prior to her passing, Lisa was a passenger in a vehicle that struck a 10-year-old boy as he stepped into the street. The accident was not reported to authorities. Lisa assisted his family with arrangements, and there was no blame placed on them as drivers. Lefteye tragically passed 19 days later. Prior to which she had been expressing that a spirit was haunting her and that it may have made a mistake by taking the kid's life instead of hers. 10 years later, her protege, Natina, was hit with a similar tragedy when she was struck by a vehicle while walking across a highway. Her death alone left unanswered questions as she was 12 miles from the extended stay motel where she lived. Her parents wanted to know what happened and why.
We're not looking to be victims. We're not seeking to be angry, but we do need a resolve.
Police tell me no charges are pending against the driver who hit her. They say the driver stopped and called for help, and her passenger performed CPR. Reed's parents say she was on the phone as she crossed the street and shared a few details with me about what may have led to the accident.
The details of her death leaves unanswered questions, as the only witnesses were the driver and the passenger, in which the police says were not in fault. But the similar details doesn't stop here. Lisa was in a red vehicle during her time of passing, and Natina was struck by a red Honda Accord. They passed 10 years apart. The little boy whom passed in the accident was 10, and Natina's son was 10 at the time of her death. Now, this could be a bit of a reach, but I am just putting that out there for the people interested in numerology. Lisa and Natina both shared the same nemesis at some point in their life. Lisa was notoriously known for once burning down her boyfriend Andre Risen's home in 1994. This relationship seemed pretty toxic, as Lisa speculated that Andre had a thing with Foxy Brown when he was featured on her 1998 track called Burning Down the House. See, that's how I play. Kind of feeling baby boys, this is Green Bay days. Stack it up. See, you had them chicks tatted up and pushed on it for the Falcons. Yeah, this is the tattoo Foxy was speaking on. Although Foxy possibly had a thing with Andre, she was involved with Death Row rapper Corrupt, and there was a love triangle between her, Corrupt, and DMX. And somewhere in between, him and Foxy split, and he will move on to Natina Reed. Now, Natina and Corrupt took a page out of Foxy's book, and they collabed on a song that seemingly dissed Foxy Brown. Possibly didn't like this, and she blasted back on track 730, where she stated Corrupt was off limits and called Natina soft. Pop star bitches with the soft image, so what I ain't with them, bitches off limits, be where I always be, see who I choose to see, although we're not together, it's hard to belong to me, see at times I think y'all bitches be confusing me, like I'm some sweet, shorty I'm still street, and not on my level, and I won't stoop, and I'm the one that got you, kicked out your old group. Natina and Corrupt were eventually engaged. They had a son together, in which whom was living with Corrupt at the time of Natina's passing. Now, it is unclear if the women patched things up. However, 3 months prior to Lisa Lopez's death, she allegedly posted on a fan site that she would whoop Foxy Brown's ass and that nobody is better than her persona, Nina. Pretty spicy. Both Natina and Lefteye faced personal struggles and were turning over new leaves towards the end of their life. Lisa Lefteye's journey was documented in her final days, where she was on a spiritual retreat in the Honduras.
I'm on a 40-day fast. It pretty much cleanses your mind. It definitely cleanses your body on just a physical level, and your body, your physical body pretty much governs your energetic.
Natina also had taken on her spiritual journey, once denouncing all secular music and spent a point of her career exposing the evil forces in the industry.
And the same demonic oppression that comes over people who have been out there in the R&B market, do you find, and this is a question that I'm sure a lot of viewers have to ask, do you find the same oppression and demonic activity following you as you rise higher, even in the gospel?
Lisa had a history of alcohol and substance abuse, and it has been alleged that Nina suffered with substance abuse as well. But surely alcohol abuse, as her license was revoked for a couple of DUI charges, hence the reason she was walking on the highway at the time of her death. Both Natina and lefteye were eclectic rappers who focused on their art and didn't fall to the over-sexualized stereotype as a woman rapper. They both embraced their uniqueness and brought a futuristic edge to their art. And apart from all the speculation, the culture suffered a loss with both artists passing before their aspirations were materialized. Therefore, let's honor Lisa Lefteye Lopez and Natina Reed, not just as musical icons, but as individuals who faced challenges, sought redemption, and left a lasting impact. Let's approach the situation with deep empathy and respect for the families touched by this complex narrative.